over the left ankle region from past 1 year, and pain was swelling was associated with pain over the swelling from past 2 months. So my patient is apparently all right 1 year back. He noticed the swelling over his left ankle region, which was gradually increasing in size and has progressed to a tender present size. The pain was associated over the swelling for the past 2 months, which was dull aching in nature, presented pain during walking and climbing stairs, and relieved on rest. So there was a history of rested movement of left ankle joint. There was no history of trauma or exposure to radiations, no history of cough or difficulty in breathing, no history of bony pain, no other swelling anywhere else in the body. So past history, he was not known case of diabetic hypertension, TB, asthma or any other comorbidities. He didn't have any surgery in the past for the similar complaints. So personal history, he was not smoker, alcoholic, he was taking a mixed diet, he was having normal sleep and appetite, normal bowel and bladder habit. Not a similar complaint in the family he was having, or no history of allergy. General examination.
The patient was moderately built and nourished. He was not anemic, not cyanose, not ictric, no clubbing, generalized lymphadenopathy or pedal edema. Vitals were stable, pulse rate of 80 per minute and BP 120/70. Examination of swelling, inspection. The swelling appeared to be of size of 5x4 in the greatest dimension. It was over the anteromedial aspect of the lower tibia and the left ankle region. The surface appeared irregular. It appeared to have a well-defined edge, extending from 2 cm above and 2 cm below the ankle region, overlying the medial malleoli and the lower aspect of tibia. The skin over the swelling had dilated veins. A scar was seen over the summit of the swelling due to the investigation, biopsy done. Area surrounding the swelling was normal. On palpation, it was not warm or not tender. Inspectory findings of site, size, shape, surface confirmed. Consistency was variable, hard in most places. Mobility, it was mobile. Restricted of mobility is seen on dorsiflexion. Percussion auscultation not relevant. There's no distal neurovascular deficit. Movements of the left ankle joint, there was restricted dorsiflexion on active movement. Regional lymph nodes not palpable. Examination of the opposite limb, normal. Systemic examination was normal. Summary of the case, a 42-year-old male with swelling 5x4 cm over the left ankle region, irregular in shape, variable consistency, hard in most places, with dilated veins over the surface, restricted dorsiflexion of the ankle, and no distal neurovascular deficit or regional lymphadenopathy. My probable diagnosis for the case is a soft tissue tumor, probably a sarcoma of the left ankle region, clinically of stage T2, N0, N0, stage 2. Thank you.
Why did you examine the regional nodes?
Extremity sarcomas, there are documented evidence saying that 3% of them can metastasize to lymph nodes.
Name some tumors that can spread to the lymph nodes.
Synovial sarcoma, angiosarcoma, Ewing sarcoma, embryonal rhabdomyosarcoma, and epithelioid sarcoma can metastasize to the
rhabdomyosarcoma.
Rhabdomyosarcoma.
Very good. What probable histological diagnosis you expect from here?
In this patient, ma'am, it can be a fibrosarcoma or a spindle cell sarcoma, or a synovial sarcoma. So,
what is it? Can you
synovial sarcoma or a fibrosarcoma is what I'm expecting in this patient, ma'am.
Why is it called synoviosarcoma?
It is actually a misnomer. It is from the cells which resemble the synovial cells. It's undifferentiated mesenchymal stem cells.
It is coming from the synovium?
Yes, it contains synovial cells, ma'am.
It is coming from
the primitive muscle cell. The name itself is very wrong. That's because it comes very close to your joint. It can occur elsewhere also. Not necessary it should come near a joint. Because it is coming somewhere, it's a misnomer. It is arising from the primitive muscle cells. They have taken a core biopsy, right?
Yes,
what are the principles of biopsy in a soft tissue sarcoma?
It should be taken along the line of future surgical incision site. Especially in an extremity sarcoma, it is supposed to be fashioned in a longitudinal way. We shouldn't raise flaps while doing an incision biopsy. And we should achieve adequate hemostasis.
Don't raise, if it's an open biopsy, do not raise flaps.
Do not raise flap, no.
And don't drain.
Do not
preferably.